Okay, let's talk Snook. Well, it's September back here in Jupiter. That means it's time for the mullet run. It's been 2 years since I was over here fishing. Last year, I didn't get to come because Hurricane Dorian just really churned up things, but it's about time to talk snook and the mullet run again, so let's do it. So what is the mullet run? Well, every year the mullet, both black, there are two kinds of mullet, black and silver, migrate down along the beach. I'm not sure how far north they start, but they come right along the beach and they head all the way down to, I think, Biscayne Bay. I asked my dad one time where they were heading and he told me they were going to Biscayne Bay to winter. Along with the black and the silver are lots and lots of what are called finger mullet. They're juvenile mullet. And these fish can number in the millions. They are prime food for big game fish like snook, some redfish, and tarpon, and sharks. So how do you fish for snook, and where's the best place to catch them? Well, let's go take a look. Well, if you've seen any of my videos on snook around the bridges, here's the link to one of those videos. You know that the snook gather in the inlets to spawn during the summer. Then a very interesting thing, the smaller, younger males actually morph and become females. And my last video where I was over at the bridge swimming, that link's right here, I didn't notice any of the great big fish over there anymore, the 15 pounds and up. I noticed mostly smaller ones. So I think what's happening is the males are turning into females and then they're leaving the inlet and coming out to the beach where they're going to patrol right along the beach waiting for finger mullet, but also feeding on their favorite food, croakers. A friend of mine, Ted, just caught a big fish on the beach the other day. And the biggest one we ever caught over here was, I think, 29 pounds. Snook can get as big as, I think the world record's 59 pounds. But most of the ones over here are really, really big fish, be 25 pounds. So when the mullet come along the beach, migrating south, the snook and tarpon and sharks get in them and there's a feeding frenzy. You can see the mullet spray up into the air. 2 years ago when I came over here, we had the red tide. Last year we had Hurricane Dorian, so I'm hoping that we're going to have a better year for mullet this year, and then a great time for fishing along the beach. Now, a lot of guys come over here to the south jetty on the Jupiter Inlet to fish for snook. They also catch them over on the north side, and we'll take a walk out here and see if there might have been any caught recently or if there's any mullet around. What's kind of interesting is the way the mullet move. Let me park the car and then I'll tell you a little bit more about that. So as the mullet are migrating south, they need a safe place to overnight. So they come in the inlets and they go in the backwaters in the bay. Usually the Du Bois Lagoon is full of mullet during the peak of the run. They swim against the tide, which means typically there's a lot of snook in the inlet, and they catch them over on the north point there on the falling tide, and they catch them right inside here on when the tide's coming in. But the mullet swim against the tide. So in the morning when the tide will be coming in, the mullet will be leaving their safe haven and heading out. Or if they happen to stay on the beach and in the morning the tide was going out and they were out here, they'd be coming around and heading back in. These fish are a little bit excited because they're migrating. Normally, mullet are very quiet fish. My great uncle Leroy used to call them banked loafers, meaning they would get up on banks of sand or shallow grass beds and things, and they don't move around very much. But when they're migrating, they're very excited and agitated. Let's take a walk out on the south jetty and see what's cooking out there. Oh, Well, I don't see any snook on the south jetty. Let's head on down the beach and we'll talk some more about what's going on. Okay, so the snook come out to the beach. And there's a little trough right off the beach where the waves break. And bait fish, particularly their favorite food, croakers, swim in that trough looking for sand fleas and things that are being washed off the beach. So snook just cruise up and down in that trough until the mullet get here. Mullet stay in pretty close, usually because there are tarpon and sharks holding them up against the beach. I used to fish over here with my cousin an awful lot at dawn, and one morning we saw two tarpon jump and cross in the air. It was really an amazing sight. I think I mentioned to you too, the biggest snook we ever caught over here was 29 pounds. So during the mullet run, there's a couple things you can do. Of course, live bait is always better than any artificial. And my cousin used to be really good. He would use a snatch hook, which is a treble hook with a weight on it, and he would throw it out and yank it fast and try and hook a mullet. And if he did, then he would just leave it out there, and it was usually successful in catching a snook. If you're going to use a cast net to catch mullet, put them in a bucket. You're going to need an aerator, keep them alive, and then it's usually rough. You see, the thing that drives the mullet is the change in the weather, and that is the cold weather and the wind from the northeast as cold fronts come down. And as they come, it gets really rough here in the surf. The more milky the water is, the better it is for the snook. The line on the side of them is actually nerve endings, so they can sense where fish are. And when the water is real milky, the prey fish can't see the snook, but the snook can sense them. So they like muddy water like that. The mullet go all the way down. When they get to South Beach, they get holed up in that corner at a government cut because the jetty's really long. And when it's rough, the snook just get in there and tear them up. I used to fish over there when I was a little kid. If you're gonna fish with live bait here, you're probably gonna wanna use a pyramid sinker. And it's because they don't move around a lot on the bottom. Your standard egg sinker will roll all over the place, but these don't tend to roll like that. So you put it on a short leader and put it behind the swivel so that it has room to move. Now, I like to walk the beach and just plug with artificials. What I like to use is just a lead head like this. Snook seem to be particularly fond of red heads, whether it's a white feather with a red head or these green tails. I've had more luck with them than anything. And you don't have to cast far. You don't need one of these huge beach fishing rods like you see them with in North Carolina, because the snook are just right outside that little trough. So you're really just gonna flip the line out there. Anyway, let's take a, before we wrap it up, and maybe, let's see, tomorrow I can't get over here. My wife's having surgery and I'm having some trees trimmed, so I've gotta take care of that tomorrow. I'll see if I can get over here on Wednesday, and we'll see if the mullet migration has begun. I know they're up further, up around New Smyrna Beach, and north of Fort Pierce Sebastian, up that way. I know they're up that far, so maybe they haven't made it down this way, but I'll check on it. Let's walk down on the beach, take a quick look up and down, and if you enjoy this video, you might check back, see if there's any action going on here on the beach, and you might consider subscribing and give me a thumbs up down below. I really appreciate it. Till the next video, have a great afternoon.